Hi, my name is Cesar Ivan. I'm a visual artist from El Paso, Texas. I work in various mediums, woodwork, furniture, metal signage. I've done quite a few metal sign pieces for like the Homeless Coalition. When I was young, I used to go to Juarez, and on the streets I would see performers up there. And I guess later on I was able to travel to Europe. And in Europe, I saw on the streets people doing, different performance pieces up there, including marionette shows. So when I came back, I wanted to see if I could find something like that. And so I went out to the streets of Juarez, but I couldn't find anything that I was really interested in. I couldn't find like small marionettes that were sold in the market. So I decided to create my own.
Go to the market.
Designed this little marionette, skeleton marionette, with using wood, rusted nails, and wire, and string, and so I'm able to control the arms and the legs. And I've sold quite a few of these. The kids especially like these. They get caught in the moment of the real skeleton dancing with maybe music in the background, so they've been a good little tool to reach people. I guess living here in El Paso has influenced the type of work that I do. In some of my work that I've done is I'll take, like, say for example, the Loteria, which is a Mexican children's game, and I'll create my own paintings. Ever since I was a kid, I was always interested in the circus and the sideshows, and with that topic of the sideshow, using actually people that I came across and living in El Paso. I live downtown, right smack in the middle of downtown, so I've met so many people, and I wanted to include them as kind of like spectators or performers. I befriended homeless people, and so I used them. They were the performers. And I created these, what I call the sideshow banner paintings, pretty large paintings. I just recently completed a public art project for the city of El Paso too. The city bought a building that Parks and Recreation took over. And my design was the whole courtyard. What I did is I did stained concrete, mosaic tiles, with some metal sculpture trees, and landscape. The little seats have actual tile chess areas to play chess, so I made a mosaic tile. These paintings that I have set up here are what I call is the Dia de los Muertos paintings, and there's quite a lot of stuff that's going on with these that influences that I used in the artwork. For example, the frames, I made those, I cut those up and welded those things together. The whole meaning behind the Dia de los Muertos, which is, you know, the bringing pain and respect to the people who passed on.